الصلاة والسلام على الرسول الكريم. It's good to have you all tonight. My name is Shabir Baradia, and on behalf of the Islamic Center of Colombia, it's good to have you all here tonight. Although it's not the most pleasant weather out there, but tonight, inshallah, we are going to introduce our non-Muslim guest to al-Islam. And let me first of all introduce, also let you know that we have an Islamic Center of Colombia on Gervais Street, right opposite Constant Car Wash. And they've been there for quite a while, about 20 years or more. And the director of the Islamic Center over there is Imam Muhammad Said Adli, and he'll be talking to you tonight, inshallah, God willing, about al-Islam. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask them. So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and introduce Muhammad Said Adli and leave the floor to him to talk to you, inshallah. Thank you very much for coming.
إن الحمد لله أحمده وأستعينه وأستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن. خلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، كل ضلالة في النار. All praise be to Allah. I thank Him and I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him, and I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen, and I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. You must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, the best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Ali ibn Abi Talib, Sha'bi ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib. In this place between the two mountains called Sha'b Abi Talib, they boycott Muhammad as a prophet, and they boycott everybody who accepted Islam. For 3 years, they did not do business with them, they did not buy or sell to them, they did not marry from this tribe anymore, not allow anybody to marry from them for 3 years. So in actuality, if we observe the life of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, before Islam and after the Islam, we found a complete different life. If we see the way how Muhammad, before he claims that he is a prophet and the messenger of God, and the way how he, after he made this claim, it was more miserable and more difficulty and more hardship for him. And if he was a liar, he will have to give up. He will have to give up this claim of a prophethood and being the messenger of Almighty God. Muhammad, he was not trying to gain a kingdom that he lost or that his family had lost before. Muhammad been presented to him the position to be the head of all the Arabian with one condition, that he give up this claim of being the prophet of God. They say, come on Muhammad, you've given us hard time, You're causing us difficulty and hardship. If you doing this because you want the chief to be the head, to be the president, give up this idea, and we be glad that we never make any decision until we consult you. But stop claiming about God is one. Stop talking about Allah is the creator and the only one worthy of worship. Stop saying that you are the prophet of God. Stop reciting this Quran. This all what we asking you. What do you want? You want women? We choose the best and the most beautiful women among our tribes, and we let you have them. 5, 10, whatever you want, whatever number you want. We gather the most beautiful women among us, we give it to you. You want to be a chief? We make you the chief. You want to be rich? You want to be a millionaire? We gather each one of us, will make a donation. And we give you money with a condition, we make you the most rich one among all of us. Tell us, what do you want? What do you want? Leave this Islam alone, leave this prophethood alone, leave this Quran alone, and you tell us what is your condition. We're ready to make a deal with you. If women, we're ready. If it's position, we're ready. If it's money, we're ready. Anything. And listen, Muhammad, if what's happening to you is something beyond your ability, you have no control over it, it may be a genie. Do you know what a genie mean? Like evil forces that you've been touched by Satan. We get the most wise and those people who know about medicine, and we try to help your condition. Because possibility is not a matter that you want women, that you want money, that you want a position, but maybe something is beyond your ability. Maybe you've been touched by evil forces or something. We be glad to go to other countries and they try to see those people who know about medicine, cure, to cure, whatever it takes to help you, we're ready to do it. We're ready for any deal. But the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he used to hear from them, he asked, did you finish? They said, yes. Say, listen, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, from the cursing devil. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, God said such, 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 and start to recite to them the Quran. This was the only answer, because it's not something that he made it up. He has no choice. God Almighty revealed to him, like he revealed to Moses, like he revealed to Jesus, and he commanded him to go and spread this word and invite mankind. It was much easier for Muhammad to come as an advisor, or to come as a person who tried to revive a mission that been revealed before. It's much better for Muhammad to come and advise the people. Tell them, as example, what about you try, let's have a better business bureau, let's try to have a better consultation about marriage, let's have a democracy, let's try to have try to be like an advisor, or to try to revive a mission which has been established by a prophet before. But was not the choice of Muhammad, because Muhammad didn't make it up. It's much easier to come and to try to teach the students and review a subject that they've been taught before, but to start a new subject is more difficult for the students. But to review something been taught before is much easier. But was not the choice of Muhammad to come to try to review a mission before, or to try to revive a mission been established before, or try to be advisor, was not the choice of Muhammad. It is the choice of Almighty God, the creator of all things, that he chose Muhammad, peace be upon him, like he chose Moses and Jesus and Abraham and Moses and Joseph and Jonah and all those prophets before. So was not Muhammad a choice to make himself a prophet? He been chosen from above the seven heavens to be the messenger of Almighty God. Before the mission of Islam, Muhammad was rich. When Muhammad became a prophet of God and he died, his dirah, the shield that he wore for protection, like when you enter the army, when you enter the war, they have something like you call it a shield, like similar to bullet proof vest. So they have shields to protect the soldiers against the swords. So when Muhammad died, his shield was been given to a Jew because he borrowed money from him. That means Muhammad, he became poor after he used to be rich. Not only poor, he became in debt. And he owes a Jew some money. And as a cradle, he have to go and give his shield or his sword or his whipping. Muhammad, peace be upon him, after he became a prophet, he refused his companions and his friends and his followers to stand up for a manner of greeting. He said, no, don't honor me like the Roman, like those people who stand for their kings. I'm not a king. I'm a prophet of God and been inspired by God, but I'm not different from you. I'm still a human being like you. So when I come, I greet you with the greeting of Assalamu Alaikum. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty be with you. You're returning the greeting to me by Wa Alaikum Assalam Wa Rahmatullah. May the peace and the blessing of Allah be with you. But you don't stand for me. You don't go and make bodyguard for me. You don't have, you understand, a special limousine for me. He refused all the things, even the manner of greeting. He refused people to stand up for him. Muhammad had to migrate from Mecca. Mecca, his hometown. This is where he born. This is where he grew. And he loved Mecca. Like any one of you would like his home and his house and his family. But because he came to the people to tell them, I am the prophet of God, and he have no choice except to tell them what God commanded him to say to them, he been driven out of his country, his hometown. Why he have to go through all these things? If he claimed something from his own self, and now he found it getting so serious, oh guys, okay, I give it up, all right. I didn't know that it's going to be so serious like this. Okay, now you let me stay, I'm going to stop. I'm going to hush, I'm not going to say it anymore that I'm the messenger of God. But he been driven, and he have no choice except to leave Mecca and to go to another state and another city. He went first to At-Ta'if, and he went to Al-Madinah, and his followers and his companions, they have to go to Abyssinia and to go to Medina later on. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to another cities to invite the people to Al-Islam, what was the response? They sent the little children, the slaves, and the little children with rocks to throw in Muhammad. And they make him bleeding. And Muhammad, he has nothing to do except ask God forgiveness for them and to be patient and continue his message and his mission. When Muhammad passed away, he didn't leave anything for his family. So it was not a matter of claiming prophethood so he can be rich, so he can give position to his family after him. And Muhammad, by being a prophet, it didn't give this prophethood to his family after him. Because we as Muslims, we believe that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, may the peace and the blessing of Almighty God be upon him, he was the prophet of God, the messenger of God, and he's the last and the final messenger to all mankind. So when Muhammad died, his wife didn't become a messenger. She didn't take over after him, not his cousin, not his grandson, not anyone of his family. And he said, me like any prophet. And the prophets, they did not leave any inheritance for their family except knowledge, the wisdom, the teaching, the guidance of Almighty God. Look to the one who took in charge after him. Was who? Was Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he was not even related by blood to him. And who else after this became in charge? Umar ibn al-Khattab. So was not a matter of establishing prophethood so his family can inherit after him. Indeed, the claim of Muhammad being a prophet could not remain as a claim after 1400 years. Could not continue to be a claim. It have to be a reality after the mission continuing after Muhammad and after the death of Muhammad. It could not be a claim. It have to be truth and reality. And we see Al-Islam and the mission of Al-Islam is spread everywhere. And even you can see it today here in the United States, and you can see it in China and Russia and everywhere. It could not be a claim after Muhammad stood up keeping this mission for 23 years. For 23 years, he continued with this prophethood and being the messenger of God until death came to him. Muhammad came with this Quran. This Quran was not made by Muhammad. How a person can discover or invent something and will go and give the credit to somebody else? I give example. Let's assume as example that I invented this tape recorder. And this is something new, is not been known in the market before. This piece of my machine, which can record my voice, or my picture, or whatever, and nobody else did something like this. And how after I invented myself, I go and give the credit to somebody else. I say, no, I didn't do it, so and so did it. It doesn't make sense. Anybody who invented something, he would like to get the credit for himself. So if Muhammad made the Quran, if Muhammad invented the Quran and put the Quran together, why he have to give the credit to Allah or God or to somebody else? What is wrong in the Quran for him to give the credit to somebody else or to say, no, I did not do it? For those who know the Quran or those who don't know the Quran, we ask in each one to go and examine the Quran and keep the examining the Quran, not chapter by chapter, but verse by verse and word by word. Can you see any defect? Can you see any mistake? Can you see anything that shameful for Muhammad to try to clean his hand and wash his hand and say, no, the Quran is not mine. It came from God, it came from Allah. The Quran is so amazing, it's so beautiful. So it's no need for Muhammad to wash his hands and to try to give the credit to somebody else. How a man living in a desert, between camels and sheep, between mountains and the sky, can come with a book that it challenges the modern man nowadays? Muhammad, being a prophet and being the messenger of Almighty Allah, and claiming to be the last and the final messenger, he came with this book, Al-Quran, which guarantees success and happiness for mankind in this life as well as in the hereafter. How a man living in a desert can come with a book that can present economic system, political system, social system? How? And he claiming that this system is good for mankind at anywhere, at any time. If so-called non-Muslims believe that Muhammad was a false prophet, if the non-Muslims believe that the Quran is not from the heaven, is not from Almighty God, is not revealed, let them show some defect. And let them show that the Quran could not stand for the mother man, that could not work for this system. We see that American system and the 20th century system been proved to fail to help the human being. This society, which is supposed to be one of the most sophisticated society and one of the so-called superpower, how many millions of homeless, how many problems of people in their social life? Why so-called superpower did not solve the problem of man in America? Why they could not find a solution for their social problems? The only solution for the crimes nowadays in America, which go rapidly every second and grow up every year, the only solution is building more prisons and more jailhouse. Indeed, mankind, indeed man's system proved to be a failure system in all life, even in their economic. Why so-called America and superpower country, they are in debt? Why they could not guarantee a decent job for each male and female of their citizen? Not even a decent job. Why they could not even provide a job for every person who looking for a job? Is this not America? Is this not the superpower? But in Islam, and only in Islam, you find a social system which has been proved by these countries that practice Islamic law that this system is good and no any system can be better than it. If the Quran from Muhammad, why Muhammad? Why Muhammad didn't give answers immediately on the spot for some people who used to come and ask him questions? Because if Muhammad making up the Quran, anybody knocking the door, oh Muhammad, give me answer about such and such. The history telling us that some people from different communities and different religion, they used to go to test Muhammad, giving him very hard questions. And sometimes Muhammad, he would say, I don't have an answer. And sometimes it used to be days before Muhammad can give them the answer about their question. So if Muhammad is making the Quran, if this is a pharmacy and I have everything in the shelf, as soon you come with your prescription, put my hand in the shelf and give you the medicine. You see? But Muhammad never made up the Quran. Therefore, when some people used to come and ask him questions, regardless if these people, Muslims or non-Muslims, sometimes he don't have the answer. And say, come later, I don't have it, I don't know. And he sat waiting until revelation come to him, so he will answer the question later on. And sometimes the people used to be laughing at him and say, look, he could not even give an answer. Yes, he could not, because he doesn't make up the answers. He doesn't give us the answers. As Almighty Allah said, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. He doesn't speak from his own desire. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. He is only revelation that he inspired. Muhammad doesn't give anything that he wants to give, but he will wait until the angel Gabriel will come to him and will give him the answer about such issue. And after this, he will tell the community or the non-Muslims about whatever it is. There is an incident for the Muslims and for those non-Muslims who read in the history called حادثة الإفك, that somebody had made a false claim against the wife of the Prophet Muhammad. Somebody had accused his wife wrongly. If Muhammad is the one who make up the Quran, he should immediately put few verses together and start to recite and say to people, my wife didn't do anything, she didn't see this man, she didn't talk to him, with no prophecy there, nothing. But the Prophet Muhammad himself, he went to his wife and he said to her, if you did something wrong, seek God's forgiveness, because he doesn't know if it happened or no. Some people have illness and disease in their heart. They made this claim, they made this accusation, and they put this rumor in the community. And the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he could not do too much about it, because he doesn't know the future. He doesn't know the unseen. He doesn't know what is going on. Only when revelation come to him. And was a very serious test for Muhammad, for his wife, and for the believers. And it took month after month. It took month after month until the angel Gabriel came from above the seven heaven with revelation from Almighty Allah to tell the Prophet Muhammad that was nothing period happened between this man and this woman, that his wife is clean from this accusation. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, after all this time he was waiting, and when the revelation came, he started to recite it. So if Muhammad make he should try immediately to find a solution, but was not anything in his hands that he can do it, so he have to wait for the revelation to come. If the Quran made by Muhammad, how Muhammad can dare to make a challenge and say, produce a similar Quran? He didn't even challenge his community only. In the Quran, there is many challenges. There is many challenges in the Quran for the society of Muhammad, for the Arab, for the non-Arab, and there is a challenges until today. If anybody, individually, or as a community, or as a society, those people who have the labs, they have the computer, they have, name it. If they really believe that the Quran been made by Muhammad, let them meet the challenges, or meet one of the challenges that in the Quran. But until today, we could not find anybody to dare to challenge the Quran or to challenge the mission of Muhammad. For a simple fact, one thing as a challenge in the Quran, that God Almighty Allah said, "Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikra wa inna lahu lahafizun." Indeed, Allah Almighty is the one who reveals the Quran, and he said, for sure, I will protect it. I will protect it. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I present this issue for you tonight. Let's assume that we'll go and get 100 copy of the Quran. 100 copy of the Quran. from different countries, 100 countries, printed by Muslims and the Christian and Jews. And let's bring 100 people in this room, and each one of them, we're going to give him a copy of the Quran. And we're going to ask them, open chapter, any chapter, chapter 9 as example. Everybody going to open chapter 9. And after this, we're going to ask them, look to verse number 7. Everybody will go to verse number 7. And after this, we're going to ask them, count three words. 1, 2, 3. And ask each person to read the word. It have to be the same word. It have to be the same word. There is no two Quran exist. You bring the Quran from China, or from Russia, or from Arabia, or from America. One Quran exists. One Quran. We are not talking about translation in English. The Quran is in Arabic. And the language of the Quran is the life language. It still exists. The Quran written on it. We speak it. I can speak it. I can read it. I teach it. And we have some people here who memorize the Quran, or at least some chapters of the Quran by heart. And this, you can look in the book, or you can hear it on the CD, or in a tape, or in a video, or somebody to recite it. It's going to be the same. The same words, not only the same words, the same vowels. If somebody claims that the Quran made by Muhammad, Muhammad is already dead. How did Muhammad manage to keep the Quran with no change in it until today? If this is any proof for anything, it should be a proof and the evidence that this Quran from Almighty Allah, the creator of the heaven and the earth, this to tell you that Muhammad, when he claimed that he was the prophet and the messenger of God, this was not a claim, but this was a reality. And indeed, Muhammad is the messenger of God and the messenger of Almighty Allah. Muhammad had came with a system for all mankind, wherever they live, regardless whatever their condition, a system not only to tie you with your creator, but a system that make you successful with your creator, as well as successful with all mankind. Economic system, political system, social system, and this is the mission of Al-Islam. I invite you all sincerely that you examine the mission of Al-Islam, which has been revealed to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, which is a continuation to all the revelation of Almighty God before. Almighty Allah, who had revealed to Noah, to Abraham, to Ishmael, to Jonah, to Moses, to Jesus, indeed he had revealed also to Muhammad, peace be upon him. And this is the truth of Almighty Allah. He revealed it to whom he wants, and he chose whom he wants. And Muhammad, peace be upon him, was the messenger of Almighty Allah and the final messenger to all the mankind. For only because the time, I try to shorten it to the best of my ability, and I don't mind to entertain some questions, or if anybody have any comments, I don't mind also to hear it. And I appreciate and thank you for your participation. And after, if there's no more questions, if no questions or comments, anything, we're going to have, I think, some refreshments here. So please be kind enough and share it with us. It's going to be free, for sure. Anybody have a question, please, it's your time now. Any comments? Yeah. We are located in 19. We are located in 1929 Gervais Street. We're beside the Greyhound bus station. Our center is beside the Greyhound station. Greyhound bus station, you could not miss it. So, if you don't have question at this moment, you would like to know more about Islam, you would like to have more material about Islam, please visit our center at your own convenience. Our phone number is 254-7242. May God bless you all and guide you to the truth. Write that number down. 254-7242. This is our phone number. My name, you can ask for anybody, you can talk to anybody, but my name is Muhammad Adli, not Muhammad Ali. Don't mix them together. Muhammad Adli, A-D-L-Y. And our place is 1929 Gervais Street. And the brother Ibrahim has the address in the end of this small flyer. Thank you very much. Thank you for coming. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا